Welcome back to the channel, guys, and in this video we're going to be talking about Workhorse Stock. This company has been down 41% in this past month alone. So I'm going to be talking about the delay of this $6 billion contract that they were supposed to have with USPS, the futures of this company, what's going to happen if they get this contract and if they don't get this contract. And at the very end, I'm going to give you guys my price prediction moving forward with this company. So stick around to the end of the video. I have a lot of great information for all of you. Hey guys, welcome back to the channel. My name is Chris. I am a dividend and value investor that just loves researching stocks, especially stocks that have a lot of potential and a lot of room for growth. I research stocks on my spare time and I love the stock market so much, I made a stock portfolio for my three-year-old daughter. And if this is the type of content you guys like and do enjoy and want to be part of the community, please make sure to subscribe to the channel, hit the notification bell, and smash the like button. In today's video, we're going to be talking about Workhorse Stock. This is one of these speculative companies that it's a high risk, high reward. This year alone, Workhorse has grown 432% in shareholder value. Workhorse is an electric vehicle company that specializes in delivery trucks. They're also currently working on drones that could also be making deliveries as well. They have strong clientele like UPS, DHL, and FedEx, and a lot of investors have fallen in love with Workhorse because they are 100% electric and they're calling this company the Tesla of delivery vehicles. This company hasn't been profitable in the last 4 years. So why is it that in 2020, Workhorse has gone up 432% in shareholder value? Well, they are one out of the three finalists running for a $6.3 billion contract with the United States Postal Service, in short term, the USPS. The USPS has been looking for an upgrade in their delivery trucks, okay? They've been wasting a lot of money on these fuels and they just want to cut back and get better mileage on their vehicles. And since 2015, they've been looking for a company to basically revamp their delivery trucks. And Workhorse has been in the running for this contract for some time now. And out of the three finalists, Workhorse is the only pure electric company that there is. And if Workhorse gets this contract, it will turn a company that's only worth millions to a company that's worth $1 billion in just a matter of moments. You know, this is very big for a company like Workhorse that could turn a company of losses to a company that's finally made some profit. And a lot of investors believe this company will get this contract. And if not the entirety of the contract, maybe some parts of the contract, you know, and as long as they get something out of this deal, Workhorse could make a lot of money for a lot of investors and grow as a company. And the CEO of Workhorse has already announced that they're gonna try to ramp up their production to try to make 100 to 150 vehicles per month. And with that ramp up, they could probably match the demand of the contract that USPS is actually offering. Now, the second question I'm gonna be talking about is, why has Workhorse been down 41% this past month? And the thing is, with this contract, there's a lot of speculation with this contract, but there has been a lot of delays with this contract that has actually slowed down the profitability of Workhorse. The announcement of the winner of this contract just keeps on getting delayed. It was supposed to be announced on October 17, but USPS announced that they will push back the announcement of the winner, but they will announce it sometime this year. They don't know, nobody knows when. It could be tomorrow, the next, or it could be December 31st. But they said that they will announce the winner before the year ends. So, like many investors don't like to wait on who's going to be the winner of this contract, okay? There's some investors that have a lot of money invested into Workhorse, and they're just anxious to see where their money will go, if it will grow, and if Workhorse will be worth the wait. And with continued delay of this announcement of this $6.3 billion contract, there's some investors that start to get worried and anxious, like, is Workhorse actually gonna get this contract or part of this contract? Fearing that some investors are actually pulling their money out and shortening their positions with Workhorse. And on top of that, there's a short seller called Fuzzy Panda that's continuously releasing new articles stating that Workhorse is misleading investors, that Workhorse trucks aren't as reliable as they may seem. So with bad press and with the continued delay of this contract, of course, the stock value would have gone down with a company like Workhorse. It does bring a lot of worrisome to a lot of investors. First off, a company that's not profitable, a company that it's only kind of hinging on this contract to actually start making some noise, bad press, and the delay of this contract just keeps holding and pushing back this company. So the last thing I want to mention to you guys is my price prediction for Workhorse. I want to give you guys two different price predictions. One if the Workhorse does get this contract, and one if Workhorse does not reach this contract, okay? Because one end, if this company doesn't get this contract, it could completely eliminate all the gains this company's made this past year. And if it does get this contract, I could see this company shooting up to the moon. A great price point to jump into Workhorse would be around $13 to $14. If you guys could handle a little bit of volatility because of the announcements of the contract and the continued delay of these announcements, then this could be a price point for you, okay? And if it doesn't make an announcement of this contract, I still think Workhorse could be a great long-term play as Workhorse continues to build this backlog on orders for this future clients and this clientele that they have as of now. And if they do make an announcement that Workhorse did get this contract, I could easily see this company reaching $50 a share. That it would be a great jump from the $15 it currently is right now to the $50 that I'm predicting that it could possibly be if it does make the announcement that Workhorse is the winner of this $6.3 billion contract. A lot of investors are anxious to know, you know, who won. A lot of investors have a lot of money on this stock. And for sure, in this company, it's really volatile, but it's high risk, high reward. If you like your chances, you can step in. If you don't like your chances and cannot handle volatility, Workhorse is not for you. But in a nutshell, whenever you're putting your money into the stock market, you're always kind of taking a risk to see if your money is going to go up or down. But a company like Workhorse, high risk, high reward, wouldn't you want to, you know, 10x your money? This company is very speculative. And it kind of, as of now, it's really relying on this $6.3 billion contract. But if you could hold on to this company for 5-10 years, this company could be worth your while, okay? Again, thank you all for watching for this video. I really appreciate the love and support that I've been getting from all of you guys. We've actually been growing the channel slowly but surely, a little bit slower than I expected, but it's great progress in my opinion. Thank you all for watching. I really love you all. Be kind to one another. Take care of one another. Be kind. Do a great deed. Tell the person to do another great deed. You know, love some stocks. My Robinhood link will be down below. If you make an account with my Robinhood link, you will get a free stock. I will get a free stock. And we'll both be benefiting. Hopefully, you know, we all get a really big value stock. Hopefully it's you, you know. Have a great day, guys. Love, much love. Thank you all.